You say your children, but what about the rights of those who killed, who brutalized, who raped? They too have rights. If you can rape, if you can kill, you cannot be called as a child. You have to be treated as an adult. But in our country we find this. Terrorists, you have human rights groups arguing for them. And you found in Tamil Nadu the most ridiculous situation, where the assembly passed a resolution that those who killed Rajiv Gandhi should be let free. Fortunately, that state has no power in the constitution on matters of such kind. And therefore the central government said nothing doing. There are people who say that LTTE is fighting for the rights of the poor people. They are a terrorist organization. We don't care who they are fighting for. But if you use terror, you have to have a mindset to finish them. So how does one develop this mindset? First, let's be clear what is our identity. Who are we? You ask an American, their textbooks say the American is the white Anglo-Saxon Protestant Christian who speaks English. Professor Samuel Huntington of Harvard. He is the propounder of this, and the whole United States has accepted it. When I asked Professor Huntington, what about those Buddhists who are Koreans? What about those Indians who are Hindus? What about Muslims? He said they are citizens of the United States, but the identity of India, of the United States, is white, Anglo-Saxon, Christian, English-speaking Protestants. So they are very clear in their mind that this is our identity and this is what we have to protect. In Britain, the present Prime Minister went public and said, Britain is a Christian nation. That's our identity. And when it was pointed out to him that there are Sikhs and Muslims and Hindus and Jews and so many others, he said, yes, they are our dear citizen brothers, but the identity of Britain is Christian. What the British did to India was exactly to destroy this identity concept. They created this Aryan, Dravidian. So the Dravidians say killing Rajiv Gandhi is okay because Rajiv Gandhi was Aryan. How did you prove that Rajiv Gandhi is an Aryan? Today, modern science through the DNA states that we all have the same DNA, north and south, east and west. Somebody said, what about the skin color of North Indians being lighter than South Indians? That the researchers said has nothing to do with race. That's got to do with pigmentation in your skin. If you are closer to the equator, the sun rays hit you directly, and therefore the skin gets darker. In the north, the sun doesn't hit you so directly. In fact, in America, there was a singer called Michael Jackson, who was a black African. He went to the doctor and he said that, I heard that if you take out my pigmentation, I'll become a white man. He said, you will. He said, take it out. He took it out, and Michael Jackson looked like a white man. So this has been fed into our brain. And there was a new movement that came up, the Dravidian movement. Karunanidhi started saying that Rama was an Aryan, Ravan was a Dravidian king. He didn't know that Ravan was born in the outskirts of Delhi in a place called Noida, in a village called Basarak. You can go there even today, there'll be a board here, there. in Hindi that we don't celebrate Diwali because we are children of Ravan. Ravan went to Mansarovar, prayed there to Lord Shiva. Shiva gave him a boon, and then he said, which can I conquer? And he found that his cousin Kuber had developed Sri Lanka, so he came to Sri Lanka and became king. Karunanidhi for a long time thought this is a Dravidian king. Finally, with my interaction, he gave up the idea. But he is still very sore about Lord Rama. And he is more sore with me because I prevented him from breaking Rama Setu. The new government has now declared that we will not touch Rama Setu and make it into a national ancient monument. When I was arguing in Supreme Court, he said, who is Swami to call this Ram Setu? Was Ram an engineer? Which engineering college he got a degree from? But then Rama took revenge. Next day he fell ill and he was admitted to hospital. And the hospital's name was Ramachandra Medical Hospital. All this was fed into your brain that we are different, we are not one nation, the British put us together. This weakens us. We must have a mindset of being the Indian. And I can tell you that the DNA studies show in the Journal of Genetics that all Indians have the same DNA. I proved it in the case of Raj Thackeray also, that his DNA and the UP taxi driver's DNA is the same. Hindus and Muslims also have the same DNA. The mullahs don't like my saying this because it means that their ancestors are Hindus. Otherwise, how can they have the same DNA as us? And I say to the Muslim, if you openly admit that your ancestors are Hindus, then we become part of the same family. You can have your own upasana paddhati, that is, you can worship, you can pray to Muhammad. We will not stop because Hindus have a tradition. We have never persecuted any religious minorities. When the Parsis came, we looked after them. When the Jews came, we looked after them. When the Syrian Christians came, we looked after them. Even the Arab trader Muslims came to Kerala, we looked after them and got them married to our families, and they came to be called Mapilai, which the Englishman called as Mopla. We also believe that all religions lead to God, not necessarily with the same efficiency and speed. You can go from Mangalore to Bangalore by road, and you can also fly to Bangalore. We think that ours is the most efficient religion in reaching you to God. But we also accept that all religions lead to God. Is there any other religion in the world today which has not come out of the Hinduism, like Buddhism, Sikhism, Jainism? A religion founded elsewhere, whether it's Islam or whether it's Christianity, which says that all religions lead to God. Only Hindu religion says that. So therefore, there is no issue. We think that this is a country with a Hindu tradition. They say, no, but Islam has also contributed. Christianity has also contributed. I say, it's true. But as Ganga flows, many rivers join it. But its name remains to the end as Ganga and nothing else. So I am saying today, if you want to fight terrorism, you have to develop this oneness that we are the same. Brahmins and scheduled castes also have the same DNA. Given equal opportunity to the scheduled caste, he will be as good as anybody else. Dr. Ambedkar was scheduled caste. He went to his teacher, was a Brahmin. He told him, with the name Bhimrao Mahar, you will never get anywhere. So you change your, take my name, which was Ambedkar. So he became Bhimrao Ambedkar. He was so good that he got a scholarship to Columbia University in economics. He went and wrote a PhD there, which is one of the best PhDs of that time on monetary economics. Then he went to London and got the law degree. Then he came to India, and then the Constituent Assembly was the chairman of the drafting committee and helped pass the Constitution of India. And congressmen always called him Bhimrao. But they called Jawaharlal Nehru Pandit. Jawaharlal Nehru went to Cambridge and failed there. All members of the Nehru family have failed. Some of them falsely claimed to have passed. How can you call Jawaharlal Nehru Pandit and Ambedkar Bhimrao? In fact, you should call Bhimrao Ambedkar as Pandit and Jawaharlal Nehru as Jawaharlal only. But we have, these prejudices have been pinned into our mind, which divides us. For years they were winning elections by dividing Hindus and uniting Muslims and other minorities. This is the first time we united the Hindus and divided the Muslims. We couldn't unite all the Hindus, because the Hindus are 80%, we united only 32%. Then the Shias voted for us, the Boras voted for us, the Khojas voted for us, the Ahmadiyyas voted for us. Even amongst the Sunnis, the Barelvi Sunnis voted for us. Only the Wahhabi Sunni didn't vote for us. And with 37%, we got absolute majority. Tomorrow, more Hindus unite and we reach 44%, we'll get 2/3 majority. So now they're saying, oh, this is Hindu consolidation. When you are consolidating the minorities, you didn't feel it was wrong. Now I'm consolidating the majorities, how can you take umbrage at it? This unity is essential for survival. There is a civilization threat today in the terrorists that you are facing. We have to look for allies now, because you've got to fight it. The Americans want us to help them in the ISIS, fight against the ISIS. Americans are very practical people. I've lived amongst them for many, many years. First as a student and then as a professor, they are only give and take people. You want to take something, then you give something. 120 crores, 120 lakh crores, not 120 crores, 120 lakh crores. And if I auction coal blocks, how much will I get? 11 lakh crores. If I auction 3G spectrum instead of 2G, all of you know, I've already explained to all of you what is 1G, 2G, 3G. So I'm saying now we are going to go from 2G to 3G to 4G, even 5G is being researched now. And each of these auctions will take place every year. You'll have no shortage of resources. Coal blocks, oil fields. Even at some stage we may have to auction thorium, because you've got 60% of the world's thorium. You will be flooded with money. Money is not the issue in India. It is the focus on preparing our people to believe that merit will be rewarded in this country and you will strive for merit. We need new innovations. We are importing oil from Arabia. Instead of that, we should now make our cars fitted with hydrogen fuel cells. Japan is doing it from next year. Slowly they are moving to hydrogen fuel cells. Should generate electricity with thorium. should link all the rivers, because there are many rivers which just go into the ocean. Godavari is, 67% is going into the ocean. Krishna is going 79% into the ocean. 46 rivers of Kerala, 98% going into the Arabian Sea. So there are, of course, rivers like Kaveri, which has no water, or Vaigai, which has no water. So you must build a water grid, and that will generate employment, improve agriculture on the way. So there, India has got enormous potential. What it needs is the population, self-confident, determined to do it, and we can once again be the world power we were. Thank you.